Hi, I'm Sue Rabati and the founder of MedShadow Foundation. I'm here today with Jonathan Block, our content manager for MedShadow, and today we're going to talk about...
About a amendment that was proposed to the Republican Party platform last week. It's known as right to try laws. What this would do is it would allow more people to get access to experimental drugs. That is, drugs that are still being tested, have not been formally approved by the FDA, but nonetheless, people who are gravely ill want access to them, because if you're gravely ill and dying, you might want to try something that has the potential to save your life.
So this would apply only to people who have a terminal illness and have exhausted every other possible drug or treatment that's out there now, right?
Yes, that's correct. In fact, there are about 31 states right now that have these so-called right to try laws, and a bunch of other states are considering them. The interesting thing, however, is that the FDA already has a program for people who have terminal illnesses that want to get access to these experimental drugs under a compassionate use program. And in fact, research has shown that most of these requests actually have been approved. So,
however, they have not, all those people have not been able to get access to the drug, even if the FDA approved the one-time unusual use, because pharmaceutical companies often can't release that drug to the person. There could be many reasons for it. The drug is not in production, so they don't have a lot of it. They could have allocated all the drug that they made for clinical trials. And clinical trials really have to be the priority for society as a whole, because in clinical trials, it's determined whether the drug is safe for general use, safe for people who are ill, effective for people who are ill, and can be approved by the FDA only after clinical trials. So clearly that has to be the priority, as heart-wrenching as it is to potentially say no to somebody with a terminal illness.
Yeah, I just want to add something to what I had said before, that even though the FDA does approve most of these requests, it's a very cumbersome process and it can also take a very, very long time. And when you're dying of a terminal illness, every day matters. And what these right to try laws do is they try to speed access to them. And this is actually a growing issue due to the fact that there was a recent working group put together by NYU Langone Medical Center, and they found that the requests for these compassionate use medicines have gone up, rose by 94% in 2014. So there's greater demand for people who are dying of terminal illnesses to get access to these drugs. So I believe that this kind of a program would allow greater access to these people. And obviously they know that these drugs are experimental, that there are risks associated with them. But I would make the argument that because they know they're dying anyway, they'd rather try something, even if it's a so-called Hail Mary, that may just work, rather than wait many, many years for it to go through the FDA approval process. And during that time, they may die. Whereas if they have access to the experimental medicine, who knows? Maybe it is something that will benefit them, and they could actually live healthier lives.
It's just trying anything. And a person who's terminally ill and their family are in a very difficult position. They're not medical professionals. They don't know what's going to work. This drug has not been approved. If there are medical complications, even if it's effective, oddly effective for their terminal illness, it could leave them with other damages, that they have no legal resource, they have no medical backup, no insurance company is going to help them deal with potentially terrible, terrible side effects. And harm, there's actual harm. There's a great example of bone marrow transplants being rushed through the approval process because this was going to save lives with breast cancer. This rushed through in an unprecedented manner, and just because it showed early benefits. And many women were harmed by it. Several women died, quite a few, tens of women died from it, and it turned out to have absolutely no benefit and actual harm. So there's a reason for clinical trials. We have to follow the system.
Just as one final statement here before we end, I completely understand your point of view, but I still believe that people should have, as the name of the law is, the right to try. They understand exactly those risks that are involved, and at least give them the option to try it. Let them make the decision instead of having a bureaucratic government agency make it for them.
Well, as they say, the old expression, your right to your personal rights end at the end of my nose. Their right to try a drug could be limiting the ability for a clinical trial to move forward. So I think we disagree on this.
I guess we'll agree to disagree on
okay.
this one.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.